Hello everyone and welcome back to today's video. Now in today's video we are going to learn about something called as feature reference or something known as parameter reference inside NX. Now this is what we say building the model using design logic. Now when we say design logic, it is all about making the model in such a way that it always retain the original parameter as it is supposed to. Now for this particular example, I have already created a sketch and you can see this is not a very great sketch for extruding directly out of the box. Why? Because I'm saying like that, because here you can notice there are a lot of untrimmed segments which are present here, okay, in this particular profile, and that will actually make problem or create problem when we start extruding this kind of sketches. It can be problem based on selection, it can be problem based on, you know, editability and all those things. But by creating this type of sketch, I am, you know, creating the sketch very easily, which is becoming fully defined, you know, in a very fast and efficient way. So what we are going to do now is we are going to use this sketch, okay, in which everything is built perfectly. And then we are going to use this particular sketch to present, you know, to create our design logic and to make sure it performs properly throughout the end. And it is not going to be a very long video, so please stay along. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, kindly subscribe to the channel because that will help me a lot. And if you have anything, you can also comment in the comment section below so that I can, you know, create different types of videos for you in the future. Now, let's get started with this. Now, first of all, what I'm going to do is, even you can try if you want to, like you can have a simple model which is built somewhere, you know, of roughly the same size or the same scale. It should have some basic parameters and some basic things. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this particular command that is extrude. Now, first of all, I'm just going to reset the command so that nothing is there present over here on the screen. Like everything for you and me is the same. Okay, so first of all, we are going to reset the command. Now, here in the section selection, that is the software is asking me to select the curve. Basically, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to select this option called tangent curve. Now this will allow me to select any tangentially connected geometry. Now here there is one small problem. There are tangentially connected geometries, but they are not trimmed properly. So in that case, what we can do is we can ask the software to follow the fillet. So as you activate this particular option called tangent curve, you will definitely get this particular option called follow fillet. Now once you do that, once you click on this particular option called follow fillet, okay, and then select any geometry around, you can see the entire body is getting selected properly, although you didn't manage to create, you know, trimming and everything properly. So here still everything is getting selected properly. Now here in the start distance or in the start limit, the value is going to be zero. So it's all going to start from zero, right from the point where the sketch is. And in the end distance, the value is going to be, for example, 9. So it is going to end exactly at a height where it is supposed to, like at 9 mm high. Okay, and from here all the fun things will begin. Now here for the first extrude, I'm directly going to click OK so that it ensures that we have completed the first extrude. Now because the sketch was an external profile which was created way before the extrude, so it will be still visible below this particular model. So if you want, you can turn around this particular model, okay, to have a good look at the sketch. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is I want to extrude these three circles. Now to do that, I'm going to click on extrude again, and this time I'm going to change my curve rule to single curve. Okay, so I'm going to select curve rule as single curve, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the circle number 1. Okay, and after selecting circle number 1, the software will directly come to this area, that is boolean. So what you can do is you can go and click back inside this area, that is section select curve, okay, after selecting circle number 1, and then select circle number 2, and then select circle number 3. If in your design you have only one circle, you don't have to do this, okay? But if you have multiple circles over here, then definitely you can take your time and do this. Now, one thing what I want to do here is, I want to make sure it is not subtracting, it is uniting. So here I can choose to get it united. Now the main part comes here. Like I want this particular extrude to go exactly 3 mm above this current extrude. We know the value of the previous extrude is 9 mm, okay? And if I want, I can enter the distance of 12 mm to get it higher by 3 mm. Okay, that is what we can normally do. But what I want to do is I want to make it future ready. So I want to use some design logic so that I can ensure that irrespective of whatever the height of that first extrude is, the second extrude should remain always 3 mm higher than the first one. So to do that, what we are going to do is here in end distance inside limit. Okay, have a good look over here. Here in end distance inside limits, in front of 9 mm or whatever the value is, okay, you have to click on this drop down or this arrow and go to reference a feature parameter. Okay, so again, I'm repeating, in end distance next to the value, you have this arrow. You have to click on the arrow, go to reference a feature parameter. Now here in feature parameter, what you can do is you can simply click on this particular feature, that is the extrude feature. And because this feature has only two parameters that you can reference, that is parameter number one is this and number two is this. So I can select this parameter which I want to reference. So this is parameter number P425. It can be different for you also. Okay, so that doesn't really matter. But yeah, we are referencing that particular parameter. Okay, and then we are using plus, okay, 3mm. So here we are not entering directly 3mm extra. We are saying that it should be higher than that respective parameter, that particular parameter. We are going to even edit it and see, you know, whether it is working properly or not later on. Now I'll click OK. Now this also works other way around. For example, there is something which we already created, like a sketch profile. Okay, and I am adding something which is later created, and I want to reference the one which is already created to the one which is, you know, or later created. So what we can do is we can use this particular things to do that as well. Now what I'm going to do now is, okay, first of all, I'm going to click on the whole command here. I'm going to reset the whole command. Okay, and I'm going to choose the type of hole as countersink hole. Okay, so here I'm choosing the type of hole as countersink hole. Now first of all, I'll define all the parameters here and then I'll start placing my holes. So the hole diameter for now is going to be 8. Okay, so here I'm entering the hole diameter as 8mm. The countersink diameter over here, it's going to be 10. Okay, so for now the countersink diameter is going to be 10mm. Okay, then the countersink angle is going to be 118 degrees for now. You can decide whatever parameters you want to, okay, based on the conditions you have. So you can decide all of these parameters, and then in the limit, in the depth limit, I'm going to select through body. So it is always going to go through the body. So it is, see, creating design logic is not only a part of, you know, having the things which are linked together, but choosing the correct depth limit, choosing the correct height and all those things is also very important. Okay, so here I'm choosing through body as my depth limit. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the center, the top center, to place my hole. So here I'm selecting the top center point to place one hole. Here I'm selecting the top center point of this to place the second hole. Again, I'm selecting the top center point to place the third hole. Okay, so I placed all the three holes over here. Okay, and once I'm done with placing all the holes, I can click OK and you can see the holes are ready. Okay, so the countersink hole of diameter 8 with a countersink diameter of 10 with a countersink angle of 118 and going through the body is ready. Now what I want to do is I want to link this boss diameter to the hole diameter, because hole diameter is something which can change based on the requirement of the client. And I want to change my boss diameter on which the hole is placed based on the hole diameter. I want my boss diameter should be always double the hole diameter. Okay, so what I can do is I can right click on my sketch. Okay, from the tree here. Okay, I can right click on my sketch and use this particular option called show dimensions. Now this will show all the dimension which was used inside my sketch. Then what I can do, I can see this particular dimension controls the diameter for my hole. So I can right click on this dimension, or I can double click on this dimension to edit this particular value. So here, first of all, I have shown the dimension and then I'm double clicking on this dimension to edit the value. Then what I want to do is I can click on this drop down next to P44. This is the name of this particular dimension for now. It is showing a value of 15. I can manually change it to 16 if I want to. But I don't want to do that. I want it to be double of my hole diameter. That is the case. So what I can do, I can click on this button. I can go to reference text and choose feature parameter. Okay, again, I can choose feature parameter over here and then select this whole feature. Okay, so this time I'm clicking on the whole feature. Now this whole feature has three different dimensions, as I told you, 8 diameter, 10 diameter and 18. So I'm selecting the one which is having the 8 diameter. So first one is what I'm selecting, that is the hole diameter, and then I'm clicking OK. So this is going to refer to hole diameter, and this is P478. Okay, in my condition, it can be different in your condition as well. And here I'm choosing multiplied by 2. Okay, so this is going to get multiplied by 2, and then I can click OK. So what will happen now is all of these bosses will be always double of the hole size. Now to check that, first of all, I'll right click on the screen and choose refresh to get rid of all the graphical thing which we just built up. Okay, so now to check, you know, whether the things are working properly or not, I'll double click on my first extrude, or I'll modify my first extrude, and rather than 9, I'll make it 25. So way higher than 12, you can say. Okay, and now if I click OK, you can automatically see this is still higher by 3mm automatically. Okay, so you don't have to worry about that. And now I'll double click on my hole diameter. Let's say I'm changing some parameters. I'm making the countersink diameter to go 12. and I'm making the whole diameter to go 10. Okay, and have a close look at the diameter now as soon as I click OK. Okay, you can notice the diameter of this particular part got increased. Okay, if you want, you can also go and check your sketch profile. So here you can see what I'll do rather is I'll show you by using measurement. So I'll go to analysis, I'll click on measure. Okay, and I'll select this particular cylindrical face, and now the measurement is showing as 10 mm radius or diameter of 20 mm. Okay, so that is how it is building up. So I hope this particular part is helpful, and I hope you got a complete idea of how this entire thing is going to get built. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. Have a great day and consider subscribing to the channel. Please leave a comment below if you like this particular video. Okay, so thank you very much. Have a great day ahead.